back on Championship Wrestling from Florida. Again, another great tag team in that of Michael Freebird Hayes and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And it's Garvin in there right now against the team of Gary Royal and George South. And it's George South in the ring right now. I'll make that Mark Fleming. Hayes in the ring now. Both these wrestlers dressed in red, and they are hot, believe it or not. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Michael Freebird Hayes. And Hayes runs Mark Fleming into the turnbuckle. A lot of people around the National Wrestling Alliance think it's Hayes and Garvin to be the number one contenders for the world tag team titles held by Arn Anderson and Kelly Blanchard. These two work so very well together. The tag, and in comes gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Garvin out of West Tampa, Florida. And it's Garvin with that big right hand. And Mark Fleming now better get to his corner and tag his partner, Larry Stevens. Or this could be over real quick. Garvin continuing to work on Fleming. Into the knee of his partner Hayes. Michael Hayes now makes the tag. A big right hand. Another one. And it's Fleming making the tag, and Hayes wants Stevens. Larry Stevens better think twice about this one. What an exciting tag team. Freebird, Michael, look at the double teaming. The double teaming by Hayes and Garvin. And Larry Stevens has nowhere to go but down and out. When we come back, you will hear from the five-time World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. Stay with us.
Jay Dillon, the world champion right here, Nature Boy Ric Flair. But when I look around, champ, I only see three horsemen at this point.
Bob Connell, if you look around and you're honest, what you see are three world champions and the greatest mind in our sport. So let me put it to you like this. If you've got the single best wrestler alive today, and you got the world's best tag team and the greatest mind, what else do you need, huh?
That about
we got money.
Yeah.
We got cars. We got airplanes. We got championship belts. We got life itself by the butt. Because whether you turkey, like it or not, and when I say turkeys, I'm talking to Dusty Rhodes, Nikita Koloff, the Road Warriors, Dr. Death, anyone else out there that can't live with life the way it is, and that's simply that you are looking at the franchise in our sport. The three world champions. That's the bottom line. I don't care what title you have, where you wear it, where you don't wear it. If you want to be something in our sport, if you want to be one of the select few, then pal, you've got to be able to be a world champion. Luger, you couldn't even hang on to that rinky-dink U.S. title, much less be a world champion. You, pal, are second rate. And whether you, once again, like it or not, you have to live with it every day of your life. You don't like Arnatelli? Tough. They're the world champions. You don't like Ric Flair? Tough. He's a world champion. We don't care whether you like it or not, because we have the genius mind that makes promoters weep and crawl and beg and snivel to book us in their arenas. Because without us, there's nothing else in life for wrestling or the promotion. as long as we are the world champions, and that may be forever.
Wrestling from Florida, the Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson in tag team action now. Going up against Steve Sampson and Bob Riddle. And it's Steve Sampson in there against Robert Gibson. What a show, what a month of January for Championship Wrestling from Florida. Morton going to work quickly on Sampson. Suplex by Ricky, Robert Gibson rather. One, two, three. That quick, it's over. The Rock and Roll Express victorious. Ricky, wait a minute, the Sheepherders now are in there against the Rock and Roll Express. Luke Williams and Butch Miller. Johnny Ace has got the flag of New Zealand. And this man is one of the most unorthodox teams in wrestling today, the Sheepherders. And it's Butch Miller and Luke Williams working on Ricky Morton with that flag. Ace now. Oh, no. No. That flag across the chest of Ricky Morton. The Sheepherders wreaking havoc on Ricky Morton. And Morton, they're going to seriously hurt. And it's Gibson out with a count. We're going to hear from the Sheepherders. There's no call for that. Stay with us, the Sheepherders, after you hear this.
Sheepherders, Butch Miller, Luke Williams, Johnny.
We told you, Bloody Yanks, that we were going to dominate the tag team wrestling in 1988 through the U.S., Bloody A. And anybody who was in the way, we were going to annihilate them, Bloody Yanks.
That's right.
So the Rock and Roll Express were in the way. And now we heard the bone scratch of Ricky Morton's leg. We heard the crack and we saw the bone splinters come out. Ricky Morton, Rock and Roll Express, no more. We got you, cause you're Bloody Yanks. We got you, cause we can't stand your music. And we got you, cause your long hair gets. And if we ever had to get you again, we'll chop that bloody hair off. Sheep herder bloody style. Whoa!
The Sheep Herders, all right, fans to the ring.
The bizarre words of the Sheepherders here on Championship Wrestling from Florida. And now the Florida heavyweight champion Mike Rotunda in the ring against Tommy Angel. And you talk about the new year of 1988, and what a swing for Mike Rotunda. He's still the Florida heavyweight champion, but now Rotunda taking the lead from Kevin Sullivan. And Sullivan at ringside gives Angel the clothesline, and Angel is flat on his back on the concrete. Rotunda out of the ring and working on Tommy Angel. And he lays him across that steel in Butman. Rotunda has always been a great athlete, but you gotta wonder why a man like Mike Rotunda, the Florida heavyweight champion, would even listen to a person like Kevin Sullivan. But he has, and he's changed. He is a changed man. No surrender, no retreat. Rotunda working on Tommy Angel. And under the tutelage of Kevin Sullivan, has become even more dangerous. Rotunda has always been a great athlete. Of course, the great amateur wrestling career. Flying drop kick by Rotunda now at Syracuse, his alma mater. You see the colors there, orange and blue. Suplex by Rotunda. The three count. And it's a win for the Florida heavyweight champion, Mike Rotunda. In just a minute, you're going to hear from Kevin Sullivan and Mike Rotunda.
The good, the bad, and the downright ugly. Live Sunday, January 24th, the showdown's in New York. The third annual Bunkhouse Stampede Final with more than 20 of the top NWA wrestlers. Only the roughest, only the toughest will be left standing at the end. And the payoff, $500,000. For a bootful of dollars, these cowboys will do anything.
Everything goes, anything goes. Don't miss it.
See us do what we do best. Double team, triple team. The finals of the Bunkhouse Stampede. The baddest of the bad.
This is Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and I'm here to tell you there ain't nothing as bad as the Bunkhouse Stampede. And there's only one way that you can get the Bunkhouse Stampede, so I want you to listen up, Death Pilgrim.
For more information on how to order the Bunkhouse Stampede Championships in your own home on January 24th, call your local cable company.
Fans, you saw him, the new Mike Rotunda.
The new Mike Rotunda.
The man responsible for
it. Yeah, that's right. First of all, we don't talk about trying to get something done. Second of all, we don't try to get something done. When I said that Rotunda would change his attitude and start hurting people, the first day he took a stretcher ride, his opponent. Now, let's show that piece of tape.
Wait a minute, Kevin. We've got a film, but I tell you, it's not very
fun.
It's something that we don't...
Hey, I don't care what you don't like. Show the tape.
All right,
it's a
man.
Warning.
And here it is. Here is Rotunda in the match.
Look at this guy. He looks like he came off a slalom. Straight through. Didn't touch a thing. And he broke his leg. He broke his leg real good. You see, this is the new Rotunda. I want to make it real clear. It's real clear. You see, this is the varsity club. So all the mummies and daddies out there, you get your plumber's sons and all the members of the Young Communist Party. We're going to hurt some people. Guarantee, Mike.
I'll tell you something. It's a new year, pal. I admit, I've been taking a vacation the last 2 years, but I'm sick of sitting in the back of the bus, if you know what I mean. I got my things together now with Sullivan by my side, my pal. The rest is all academic. I'm coming after everybody, and everybody I want, I'm going to get. Because I'm going to be a champion, I'm going to retire a rich, rich man, and you're not, my friend.
Get ready to take a stretcher ride.
Kevin Sullivan and Mike Rotunda, fans.
When we come back, fans, we're going to tell you about the dream match, and you'll see Lex Luger. Don't go away.
February, the Dream Match Sweepstakes. Your opportunity to pick the dream match. You're going to pick it, and you're going to pick the participants in that match. Also, each week during the month of February, Jim Ross, we're going to have fabulous prizes, watches, stereos, free vacations, any number of prizes, but I tell you, you got to enter to win.
And no doubt about it, this is the fans' opportunity to select the one match that they would like to see on national television or wherever it may be. Send your entries on a postcard. You cannot win if you don't enter.
Right.
And Bob, they can't enter if they don't know this address.
That's right, and here's the way you enter, fans. You send a postcard, a 3x5 postcard to NWA Dream Match Sweepstakes, NWA Box J, Keysville, New York, 12944. Now, be sure you write that down. NWA Dream Match Sweepstakes, NWA Box J, Keysville, New York, 12944. It's going to be a great month. The Dream Match. Fabulous prizes, fans. Be sure you enter. The championship is on the line here, fans. One fall, 20-minute time limit this match.
Referee Dick Worley having some words with Dick Murdoch. Well, I think we have all the preliminaries out of the way, and I think we're ready to go.
And Murdoch and Nikita Koloff now circling around the ring as they circle each other. Come together near the center of the ring, and Murdoch's going to be back to the corner by the champion with that championship on the line. We talk about Murdoch, talk about the money that Cornette has put up. Murdoch, the ultimate bounty hunter. Dick Murdoch will do anything for money, Jim Ross. Doesn't matter what it is. As you say, he'll break arms, legs, or anything if money's involved. You put the green up, and Murdoch will go after it. That's what he wants.
He's indeed a mercenary. He's a man that is one of the most tenacious individuals in the sport of professional wrestling. He's a veteran. He has held many, many championships. And Nikita Koloff, one of the many young lions in the National Wrestling Alliance. A man that has proudly held the television championship since he won the unification match with Terry Taylor at Starrcade on Thanksgiving night.
Again, he had Murdoch back to the corner. He had a big hand right around the throat of Murdoch. And when he drew back the big right, Murdoch just sort of cowered down in the corner. But I tell you, you got to be suspicious when that happens with Murdoch. You know the wheels are turning in that devious mind of his, and you can expect most anything when Murdoch backs away like that.
He's a very unpredictable man. And speaking of unpredictability, the very bizarre Kevin Sullivan will be out later in the hour with Mike Rotunda, which is a story in itself. Some big news surrounding the Mike Rotunda situation. And this great crowd here in Baltimore. Thousands upon thousands on hand here, yelling Nikita. Nikita has strong partisan support in this tremendous crowd here at the Baltimore Arena. And he's going to need every bit of it because Murdoch is double tough.
Boy, Koloff shows you his power there. Nikita just slamming Murdoch back to the corner in the turnbuckle. Big, strong individual, but in against the rough one. And a real tough one who has a mean streak all the way down that back of his, Dick Murdoch. And Murdoch will do anything to you when he gets the opportunity. He just did as he went to the throat of Koloff.
Jim Cornette discussing the art of officiating with Dick Worley. Murdoch taking Nikita Koloff down. Murdoch is a man that can certainly control the tempo of a match. He's a man that is probably one of his greatest fortes is taking advantage of his opponent's mistakes. But never forget, he's got the disposition of a rattlesnake.
When you talk about a rattlesnake, if he gets you hurt, boy, you can believe Murdoch's going to stay right on top of you. He's going to work it over. He's got that arm. Look at him. Put the pressure to that arm and that shoulder of Koloff. And if he could, he'd pull it right out of there. That's the kind of man Murdoch is. He asks no quarter, and he certainly gives none.
That's exactly right. And Murdoch is really wrenching the big arm of Nikita Koloff. And now Murdoch outside. He does a great deal of damage right here on the floor.
Murdoch out of the ring, down onto the floor. With that arm now across the apron of the ring, driving an elbow, hard to the muscle in the arm of Koloff.
Murdoch has got his game plan very sound. He's going to take Nikita down to the mat. He's going to try to take the tremendous upper body strength that Nikita Koloff has and let it degenerate through the use of this arm bar. And Murdoch twisting the arm back against the grain. He weighs 285 pounds. He's 6'5", and he's utilizing his weight and his leverage very effectively here on Nikita Koloff.
He's got that height advantage, and that gives him that leverage, and that's the way he's using it on that arm and on that shoulder of Koloff as he gets to his feet. As the hand of Koloff held to the mat by the foot as he stomps away at the arm, Nikita Koloff, one half of the superpowers, along with his partner, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And by the way, when I think about Dusty Rhodes, boy, they're coming out of the woodwork to challenge Dusty Rhodes for the United States title, and especially one who's hot on his trail after that title left, Bobby Eaton.
Exactly right, Bobby Eaton after Dusty Rhodes. Dan Lane has his sights set on Nikita Koloff as well. But right now, it's Dick Murdoch. And you got to think that even though Murdoch would love to win this championship, no doubt about that for Jim Cornette. Cornette would just be happy to have it in his camp, no doubt about it. But Murdoch's primary mission, you got to believe, with Jim Cornette, is to put Dusty Rhodes down for the final time.
That's right. Put him down, put him out if he can. And I'm sure that's what Cornette has in mind.
How would you like to run into this army in a dark alley? Well, you don't have to if you watch a Sunday edition of World Championship Wrestling. Well, let me tell you something. You're going to see an exciting six-man tag, and I'm talking about the Army.
World Championship Wrestling, 5:30 Eastern on the Superstation tomorrow afternoon.
Spinner ring continues, fans, and Jim Ross. Murdoch has had that arm. He stayed right with it, really putting the pressure to it. But here comes Nikita back.
What a collision, Murdoch. And Nikita had him. Murdoch got the best of it, got that knee up. Murdoch is a veteran and a man that has held titles around the globe. He's still one of the toughest men, if not, he's got to be in a class of the top four or five of the toughest men in wrestling. And lateral press by Murdoch and Nikita Koloff with that tremendous strength kicked out.
Alan Cornette now is complaining about he wanted that count to be quicker, the 1-2-3 to be a lot quicker. When Murdoch came off with that block and Nikita hit the mat, again, you saw it in that killer instinct in Murdoch as he went right back to that arm.
Murdoch is flawless when it comes to setting out a game plan and following it. But Nikita cutting right with a foot coming in. It's not going to hurt Murdoch's looks, but it certainly inflicted some pain on the big Texan from Waxahachie.
Boy, he got a big 14 right square in the face as he came charging in that time. Koloff got the foot up. Murdoch caught it full force right in the nose and the mouth.
Well, he doesn't have any front teeth.
It could have been anywhere, knowing Murdoch.
No doubt about it.
I'll tell you.
It's going to be interesting to see how Murdoch gets along with Jim Cornette and Nikita Koloff now. It's not going along with Murdoch whatsoever, quite obviously, as he buried the right hand to the jaw of the big Texan. Murdoch right above us, and he looks to be on Dream Street. Some old rough country road out near Canyon, Texas somewhere.
Oh, you're right, Jim. Now look at Koloff as he comes with a snapmare. Murdoch on the mat near the center of the ring. High in the air with the elbow drop. One thing you can say about Cornette and Murdoch now. Murdoch, I'm sure Cornette has put a lot of money on the line. You had to get someone the caliber of Murdoch, the bounty hunter. But you know he's got a lot of money on the line, but he's going to be sure that Murdoch earns every dollar of it, too.
Well, Murdoch has not been one known to have a manager. Over the years, Murdoch has pretty much been a lone wolf. But with Jim Cornette's involvement with him, you got to believe that he is going to... He's paid him a lot of money, and Murdoch right over here by us. He measures him and just slams that elbow down in the chest and throat area of Nikita Koloff. Murdoch is so physical. You can hear that thud bobbing all the way around this building.
Now he's got that belt, that championship belt, as he draws it back. And Murdoch has done the most of his damage out of the ring when he's had Koloff across the apron.
Anytime Murdoch signs a match, he just has to end up in the concession stand or in the top rope, wherever that may be. That's the kind of man that he is. This is one of the greatest challenges of the career of Nikita Koloff, and the fans are seeing it right here on the National Wrestling Alliance. Boy, this is going to be a great hour. Look at Murdoch biting.
There it is. As we said, Murdoch will do anything, fans. He wants to win, and that's all that Murdoch has in his mind. He'll do it all, and you just saw him as he bit Koloff right across the face.
Murdoch with a big right hand, and Nikita Koloff is indeed in trouble here. The World Television Championship is on the line in this contest.
Murdoch just measures Koloff when he draws back for those rights. Takes just slow, perfect aim, and then lets it fly. That one blocked by Koloff. Good block. All right, fans, back to the action in the ring, and Murdoch now still on top of Nikita Koloff. As we return to the action in the ring, he had Koloff back to the corner, came with that hard elbow smash, power slam, as he lifts him high to the air.
And we're inside 4 minutes in this 20-minute time limit for the World Television Championship, and Dick Murdoch has certainly controlled this match for the most part of it. And Murdoch's up in a very dangerous position. Nikita's up there. He's got to bring him down there.
Jet planes, world titles, yeah, you're on top of the world. There's only one place to go from here. It's a long drop, and the total package with the one kicking you off the edge of that cliff one at a time.
The total package, Lex Luger fans, we'll see you next week. And until then, for Jim Ross, so long for now.